All right, Mark, it's 12:05. That's actually a couple minutes fast, I think. But I'm going to go out here to the garden I was at when we were talking on the phone earlier. Oh, yeah. Got my cane with me. I didn't have it with me earlier. I'm just going to show you what I call the disgusting condition of my tomatoes. See these torch sunflowers? Big winged butterflies get on these torch sunflowers. We planted some of these late in the year off the back porch. I put one over there. It's about 3.5 feet tall, 4 feet tall. These are. This is the cheap shed I bought. And I had my solar panel inside there because of the wind. Yesterday it was so nasty. I got an alarm for something. It's probably going to tell me 9/11 was an inside job. View. All the bears playing Texas like I give a shit. I happened to put them in there a long time ago when I saw the schedule. Anyway, the wind almost blew this off over. Peppers over here by the side of the house. Doing okay. That's about almost 3 feet tall. And we're getting some peppers off of them. Been getting them off. Right there. That's a bell pepper back there. Finally, we got one bell pepper. I thought I planted about 12 bell peppers out here, but there's that one. That one there I know was supposed to be a bell pepper. No peppers. That looks like a small bell pepper. And then I'm going to make this fast because I want to show you the rest of the garden over there without it getting too long-winded. A little bit. I didn't see you come out here. Are you up front? Oh, okay. I saw a little bit out back here. I didn't know she was out here. You see that big winged butterfly right there? We're still getting a lot of those. Not a lot. I'd say about 8 or 10 of them. If that. Maybe a little less than that. There's some flying around over there. But anyway, the okra. See, this was corn. They had corn up on the hill there. I didn't realize that until after I had planted this stuff. And it put us about 6 years of corn we got out of 100 and whatever. Pissed me off. Broke it all up. And then we got this okra right here. Too close together. Then online they tell you plant 12 to 18 inches apart. I'd say about 28 to 36 inches apart. Because you see how close it is? It looks like a little, looks like a Vietnamese jungle. See, getting bare up there. It's like six feet, 6.5 feet tall, 7 feet tall already, 7 feet. See, here's the tomatoes. Look at how bad these things look. I was out here and I got, two very large hornworms off of here, and I've got a small hornworm and two of those brown with the yellow stripe on it off the tomato plants. But you see, like I say, there's a flower. There's a few plants out here that got a small flower on them yet. I'm hoping the butterflies, or we had some bees out here yesterday, so there's a flower on that one there, I see. And I see one or two others. I'm not going to find it right now, but just to show you the deplorable conditions of these things. Look at that. I had them all in cages, and the worms, I was getting pissed off with that, so I just took them out of the cages mostly. You see how they're on the ground? I figured that would get the worms, but evidently, don't matter really. Right there, you can see is a flower. See, I'm looking at the leaves over the camera to see if I see another damn worm. I don't have my knife with me. I've been cutting the suckers in half. And then three pieces. I'm pissed off because they're taking away my food. But that's the tomatoes out here that are so mad this year. That one there was the healthiest one. I planted this one out here from this one. I planted it out here. Oh, no, I take it back. This one right there, you can see at the very bottom there, it's a brown, looks like a stick coming out of the ground. At the beginning of the year, if you look at a previous video, you might see it. There was two brown leaves on that, two small brown leaves on a little stem, and I thought, well, and then it had a little piece of a green leaf on one, so I just went and watered it and started getting it liquid fertilizer, and it's coming back now. It's getting like, I guess this is disease, and you can see that on the leaves. So I just, damn, I got to do this with two hands. Damage the plant. I just pulled this whole branch off. I know that's not good, but. At this point, whatever. I see there's flowers on this one right here. Again, I can't see it at the viewfinder with the sun out here, but there's some yellow flowers on this one. I know I see them. One over there. Yeah, there's about five or six yellow flowers on here. And I put a couple okra on the back of the garden early in the year. There's one, two, three, four okra plants on the back here. But these are purple hull peas and black eyed peas. Those are growing fairly good. The leaves are getting all around the openings where I had them coming off these trees. These are diseased fucking leaves. And I'm not saying it is. I'm not a gardener per se. I'm a makeshift amateur gardener. But these leaves to me are diseased, and they get in the openings where the plants are, and that just diseases the plant. So I planted a white northern bean. Ouch! I think, no, not there. I planted them over there. But anyway, this one's coming. It was almost died off. See how this one looks right here? That right there. That's how that looked. But look at it watering now, growing now. Look at the binding all the way up here. You can see right there from the previous one, that dead one. I'm trying to grow something out here, damn it. But anyway, we're going to cut this open. You see the walkway in between these two gardens? That's what we're going to do back here where these beans are, is where the walkway be. It won't be as wide, but it'll be in the middle here. We'll have it cut open. There'll be four gardens out here. This plastic is going to come up next year in spring. We'll till it up and we'll put maybe tomatoes. I don't know what else right now. I just know tomatoes are going to go up here. Peppers maybe too. See, here's another one. A bean plant. Couldn't even tell you what type it was anymore because I put so many different beans out here. That should be two northern beans, white beans, people call them in the south. They're growing there. Same thing here. I think this is supposed to be two white beans, northern beans. But you see the leaves down in there? You see that right here? See this stuff? I tried digging this stuff out, man. It gets up underneath the plastic, and then the rain rains it in. If it's diseased, hello, it diseases the plant. So I made these cheap-ass makeshift fences for them to crawl on, and between my knees and my wife's ankle and her hip. This has been rough, man. Again, every year it's rough. Cucumber that was dying off, and I started watering that. I put the sprinkler out here. I've had it out here three times now. Do it over there, do it in the middle, and then over here, and then up here. And let it run for about 45 minutes. 30 minutes at least. Not 45, about 30 minutes. And these all start coming back. But see, again, diseased leaf. I mean, it doesn't do no good. I can do this all day and come back out here in 20 minutes and there'll be leaves all over this stuff, which I believe is what's hurting the plants. These are heirloom. Everything is heirloom out here, except this is a red oak and a pin oak and some kind of, what do you call it, mutt tree. It's all kind of, I don't know what it is. But in the back there, you see there's a large winged butterfly and the torch sunflower. Yeah, that's going to go all the way to the edge back there where they're poisonous, where the grass is. You can see the high weeds right there in the back. So it's another 15 feet beyond where I had the last ones. It's going to go all the way down, and then you can see the line basically where this one was. I'm going to make it even back up there too and come up this way. So we'll have a big giant U with sunflowers. The torch and hopefully the mammoth sunflowers. I have those seeds. They're all mixed though now because I don't know. I had so many sunflowers out here, man. There's my big wing butterflies right there. Now it's September 11th. 9/11 was an inside job day. There's a couple butterflies on there. So they'll get on the flowers of the okra and whatnot too. And hopefully help just keep them producing a little bit. I figure about 3 weeks from now, we'll have to get some saws and cut them trunks because they're thick. They're like little trees and whatnot. Yeah, so we have a bonfire here maybe Sunday. My friend gets up here from Illinois. If it's not wet, if it doesn't rain, we're going to make a little bonfire over there. So, all right, you see the poisonous cotton, the Monsanto bullshit all around us? That's 50 feet off the garden, and then back there it's about 100 feet. And across the road, the all Monsanto cotton. All the toxic poison shit sprayed all over that. I mean, that is one of the worst ones they've even said. It's got the most toxic poison sprayed on it, is that cotton. And I blame that on killing off all my sunflowers. There's one right by CJ's grave. That would be a Titan sunflower. I should cut that out off sometime today. But had a couple big ones here. If you look at previous videos, you see there was a giant one in the back. There was a mammoth one, gigantic. So that's the garden.